Hey everyone, it's me, James, and today I'm really excited. I got a special shave to me planned. This is going to be my British shave. I would say English, but I'm not positive that all these products are a product of England per se, so I'll just say British shave. Went to Legends, got a haircut, and now I have me some Trumper's Skin Food. And let me tell you, it's the first time I've had this product, and man, oh, if you love lime, this is what you want right here. It matches with this well, which will be my aftershave. And for my shaving cream today, I'll be using the matching shaving cream. And I had to lather it yesterday. One of the things about these tubes is they come with the foil that's over the top, but the cap's designed so that you just pop it and you're ready to go. So yeah, I've already got it in my Lady C Creations bug. So it's about a digit's length of cream. And my brush that I'll be using, I'll be bowl lathering today, is my Simpsons P8 Best Badger in Faux Tortoise, which is a beautiful brush. This is a limited edition for the Shave Nook. Love this brush. Gorgeous, performs well. Don't get a lot of funk from it. A little bit, but not too much. It kind of reminds me of, I don't know so much. I mean, you can tell it's animal product, but not heavily so. But the one thing I do kind of like more about the animal brushes is that they retain the scent of whatever you had in there before. So if you have that, brush smelling thing like Jaime, you'll smell what's in there. So I kind of enjoy that aspect of animal brushes. So I'm just gonna put just a some water in there, which is probably about 3/4 of a teaspoon, and swirl it around. It's warm water, not hot. More towards a temperate warm than anything hot. Swirl it around a little bit so the water's getting a little bit. Picking up some of the oils from the soapiness from the cream there. What I'm going to do is now I'm going to take that and let the slick goodness just kind of come in there. Use it kind of like pre-shave concept, just kind of let it sit in there. And there's still about a quarter teaspoon left inside of here. And I'm going to go ahead and start with that. And let me tell you, this stuff smells great, fantastic. Robert Gid hooked me up yesterday, did a good job. And your son was gracious while you were out. So, Robert Jr. was great in servicing my needs there at the counter. Alright, so I'm pretty much incorporated into the brush at this point. I don't really bear down to flatten my tips on brushes. And with animal hairbrushes, I've gotten myself into the habit of not swirling anyway. I just go back and forth. Put about another half teaspoon in here. And get this creamy goodness going. I gotta say, when I lathered this in my hand at work yesterday, towards the end of the day, getting ready to come home, and I was like, while I'm running this last query, I'll go ahead and go to the little break area where we have a sink and do a quick test lather, because the smell is just so amazing. And I gotta tell you, it's great. Quite pleased. A little bit more. About another half teaspoon. Starting to peak. Get in there. Oh man. It smells amazing. See it peeking in there. Look at that. It's very nice, very lovely. Awesome, awesome. You cannot beat Trumpers in the commercial market for scent. And that's what I've noticed. Very, very close. To what the real thing is. So they're using lime extract. About another quarter teaspoon of water there. Oh yeah. Look at that. There we go. That's what I'll use. Man. Just a very great looking lather here. Very minute bubbles. Rich, creamy. Oh, very nice. Shaverage.
Gatorade, cool blue. Yum.
Here's my razor, the Edwin Jagger 3-piece 3D 14. Love this handle, love the look of this one. Head's always the same, but just very nice. I like the way the knurling comes out on this. Beautiful. The blade I'll be using is a Gillette 7 o'clock yellow. The sharp edge. Which traditionally for me has been a good blade. Very solid, sharp, hasn't been harsh to me, so we'll see how this goes. And for the most part, the waxing stays towards the center, not anywhere near the edge. Which is always a bonus for me. The way I like to do it is place it on the top cap so that the one and two are showing up to me. the base plate over. And the handle carefully. Guys, be careful when you do this. Make sure you're tight enough on this guy so that, and not overbearing on this, so that you don't do like my son did on that one video and spin it on you, cut yourself up. There we go. Nice, secure, beautiful blade alignment. There we go. All right, so I'm gonna dab my cheeks real quick. Just got out of the shower not long ago. And I'm also not necessarily British, but I'm wearing Khan's The Stray Whisker shirt. Oh, look at that lather. Man, that smells great. Beautiful lather. It's not the heaviest in scent, light medium scent, but man, does it smell true to the scent, which is a bonus in my book. Beautiful, beautiful scent. Look at that creamy goodness. Wow. Oh yeah. Let's look at what it looks like right now in the bowl. My brush. Creamy goodness. Melted ice cream. Set that down. Warm the razor, and here we go. Man, I haven't shaved in a few days, and already getting a beautiful, beautiful shave. Oh yeah.
I don't drink coffee, I take tea, my dear. I like my toast on the
fine for me. I like to leave a little bit of lather on the head when I'm going around my sensitive area here on my Adam's apple. Just that extra slickness from the cream there and the extra cushion just makes it feel better for me. So when I go over those sensitive areas, I try not to rinse right before I get to them. Not necessarily uncomfortable, but I'm kind of surprised that yellow was being slowed down by a girl. So everyone knows, Rocket City Shapers meetup with Steve Walker, the Rocket City Shaper. I think he's in there. Let's see. I am crushing your head. I am crushing your head. All right. Hope to see some of y'all there. Get a little shaverage. No burning, no irritation. Be yourself, no matter what they say. Be yourself, no matter what they say. Oh, yeah. Be yourself, no matter what they say. I'm legal and I'm safe. Alright. Okay. That's what's going on in the bowl. Very nice. Look at that. Smells great. So we're still waiting to hear from the Air Force Academy to see how baby girl's doing. As far as the selection process itself goes. Very nice. Still planning for another pass. Let's go ahead and go for pass two. Not the slickest stuff, but it's definitely serviceable, guys. So just because it's not slick as snot doesn't mean that you're not getting something good. And more importantly, my skin doesn't feel dry now. It feels plenty nourished, supple. Alright, rinse and I'll be right back. Here we go, lather up for times three. Thank you. obviously the Brit Shaver, John Newton, put out a video not too long ago. Spring Shave, I haven't watched it yet. I gotta get to that. John, nice to see that you came back and did a video. Of course, TSE's been going hog wild now that he's been refreshed and rejuvenated and back in. Nice to see you out there, Chris. Consistency for my lathers. That's what I've noticed for me. So something to think about as you guys are out there doing your thing. Even going on vacation somewhere, you know? Keep that in consideration. Feels good. Very nice. All right. There we go. Oh man, this feels really nice. It's a rich lather, even though it's not the thickest, you know. You can still feel that there's it's hard to describe, but like if you ever made whipped cream out of half and half, that same type of feeling. So even though it's not thick like cream cheese, you know, it still has a richness to it. All right, I'm gonna clean up and I'll be right back. Thanks. All right, I'm back. So I cleaned up a little bit. And again, that was with the three-piece Edwin Jagger 3D14 because of the handle. And now I'm gonna throw on some Thayer's Lemon. Excuse me. Did that slap for Jaime? There we go. Use my hands real quick. The brush. The Simpsons P8 limited edition faux tortoise. Oh yeah. This will be dry in a couple days. Oh, look at that. Okay. Again, benefit of a natural brush is that you get the stink in there. The good stink. Alright. Pat my face dry just a bit. There we go. And now, throw on some of this skin food. Don't know if you need to shake it. Don't think it would be bad to, right? And it's got like a suntan lotion type restrictor. Don't know necessarily how much of this is needed, but I'm not thinking too much. Well, probably just under pea size there. There we go. Smells good. Oh, very light. Not too oily. A little tacky, but from what I experienced yesterday when I also tried it briefly is that that kind of goes away after a little bit. So you won't feel tacky all day, nor greasy. All right. And again, the shaving cream I used was the Trumper's Limes. Oh, just great stuff. Yum, 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 yum. And now, whoops, there we go. Forget, it's just that. This stuff smells amazing. It just doesn't last all day. Man. The little bit of whiff of alcohol you get along with it, it kind of reminds you of a margarita. Oh, just, man. Oh, yeah. There we go. Oh, yeah. Love it. Man. Great stuff. All right, everybody. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for being a part of this channel. I got some exciting news coming up here soon. Please stay tuned within the next couple of weeks, and I'll bring that out to you. Also, my plan right now is to have some giveaway items for the Rocket City Shavers Meetup in Huntsville, Alabama, March 19th. So probably somewhere in the evening time when we're all gathered together at the Yellowhammer Brewery. We'll play it by ear and see how it goes. Thank you. God bless you all. Have a great weekend. And until I see you next time, thanks for watching.